Did MSI just pull off one of the greatest magic tricks by making cables a thing of the past? Are they ushering us into a new golden age of wireless PC building? Okay, not quite. MSI's Project Zero does, however, offer a new way to build by simplifying cable runs. This new system offers some really interesting glimpses into a new form factor that solves some problems while also introducing some new challenges. And we're gonna talk about all that right here, right now on Robeytech. If you've been keeping a keen eye on the major players in the PC component space, especially since Computex 2023, you've probably seen a few new form factors for motherboards and video cards that don't necessarily change the size of the parts, but instead how they get their power as well as how you connect to them. These proofs of concept have a very specific goal in mind, to rid PC builders of unsightly cables. Though, I mean, my whole life is built on cable management, Brian. What are we gonna do? The thing is it's more about limiting the cable connections to the front of the case. Okay, whew, I'm safe. The back of the case can still be a nightmare. Now you might be asking, Robey, how is the sausage made? How are they doing this? Well, it's a good thing you asked because we were gonna tell you anyway. And I promise it's not as traumatic as learning how actual sausage is made. Pretty gross, just saying. Basically, they moved most of the connections to the back of the motherboard. By doing this and by opening up sections of the motherboard tray inside of the PC case, most of the cables in the PC are hidden away from prying eyes. We'll talk more about that most of the cables a little bit later. Enter MSI's Project Zero system, not to be confused with an entry in the Fatal Frame series or an emotion-suppressing Gundam piloting system. This system has a very specific objective, to disappear cable. With Project Zero, MSI is testing the waters of back connect components. So far, MSI has a few options for motherboards as well as PC cases for the lineup. For motherboards, MSI has three to choose from. The AMD-based B650M Project Zero Micro ATX motherboard, which retails for $229.99 over at Newegg, the Intel B760M Project Zero motherboard for $209.99, and the Intel Z790 Project Zero board for $279.99. Each one of these motherboards has a back connect layout, which means they are going to need very specific PC cases to accommodate the new connection locations. Fortunately, MSI has partnered with companies like Li & Li, Thermaltake, Inwin, and more to grow support for back connect motherboards. I mean, dude, if the Li & Li 0-in-1 Dynamic has it, dude, it doesn't matter. Every PC is taken care of, right? Does anybody even build in other cases? And for smaller motherboards in the series, MSI has Project Zero PC cases like this one right here, the MSI Mag Pano M100R PZ. This panoramic case, hence the Pano in the name, is available in black or white for $109.99, and it comes with four ARGB fans, three reverse blade fans for front intake, and the other regular guy for exhaust right there in the back, as well as an actual ARGB controller module. Now, before we get too far ahead of ourselves, can we just point out how actually very cool the panoramic front kind of is. I love that MSI went with something that takes from some cues from other panoramic cases like the Height Y60, the Height Y70, but they put their own spin on the whole thing to create some visual interest and something that is very uniquely theirs. So let's talk about what we put inside of this build. For CPU, we use the Ryzen 7 7800X3D, which means that we're using MSI's B650M Project Zero motherboard, which I have to pause because MSI really did do a stunning job on this motherboard. For memory, we have 32 gigs of Kingston 6000 Megatransfer Fury DDR5 RAM, which also looks ridiculously sick in here. And for storage, we're using a 1 TB MSI Spadium M480 Pro NVMe drive. The CPU is being cooled by MSI's MAG Core Liquid 240R V2 240mm radiator. For the GPU, we're using MSI's Gaming X Trio RTX 4070 Ti in white. And all of this is being powered by the new 850-watt MSI MAG850GL PCI 5 PSU. The one thing I do wanna say is that all of the components that are in here, we'll talk a little bit more about this later, but the AIO and the GPU are standard. Everything else that we kind of talked about, the case, the motherboard, and everything is all part of the Project Zero project. So basically, what we did is we crammed as many MSI parts into this build as possible to give it the ultimate Project Zero experience, with a few things, again, not being Project Zero. Now, if you were expecting to build this machine today, with these exact components, it would come out to a little over $2,000. But here's the deal, if you want the ultimate Robeytech experience that doesn't cost $2,000, you go ahead and slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring the notification bell so that you don't miss a video like this one in the future, and it's free. Okay, so you're seeing this thing all put together, and it's looking amazing, I might add. But you might be wondering how this all comes together from a build standpoint. If we flip to the back of the case, we get a better look at how Project Zero is doing its thing. As we mentioned earlier, the M100 has openings to allow builders to access connections on back connecting motherboards like the Project Zero B650M. And I have to point this out because it's so simple, but it totally makes sense. If you look at a motherboard like MSI's MAG B650M mortar, the placement of these connections is nearly identical to the Project Zero board. The only difference is that the connections are on the back of the motherboard instead of the front. Now, thanks to the placement of these connections, cable management is fairly similar to a normal build. Hold up. I know what you're thinking. Robey, there aren't supposed to be any cables. Isn't that what the zero of Project Zero is supposed to stand for? Listen, MSI never said it was a cable-free system. You're still gonna have to manage cables. Whew, I was worried there for a minute. We're getting a bit off course, but this does change a bit of the building experience. Overall, building the Project Zero PC had a number of conveniences, and it presented us with some new challenges along the way. Having all of the cables in the back of this case really did make the front and side view look absolutely immaculate. Whether it's power, USB connections, fan headers, or ARGB, it all connects back here, except for the AIO cabling and the GPU power connector, because technically they're not Project Zero components. And I'll talk a little bit about why MSI did that a little later on. But one thing I will say is that at the time of this video, MSI didn't have a GPU with hidden cable connects. Like we said, this is their first outing for Project Zero. It will be interesting to see if they take cues from Gigabyte's Project Stealth, which you can actually go check out the whole video for that right there, because that one, they hit everything, including the connections to the motherboard facing side of the GPU. Or if they're going to redesign the motherboard to supply power through a yet to be seen type of connection, which we've heard rumors of companies doing that. Whatever the case may be, the GPU cable is visible, which isn't too terrible, but it seems kind of weird to have like no cables, and bam, suddenly there's a cable. This just means that you're gonna wanna finesse it into place so it looks nice and neat, because I don't know, if it's the only cable, it's gotta look neat. If the absence of cable management is unnerving, let's just look at the rear of this case one more time. Again, there are lots of options for cable management. There are a number of well-placed tie-downs here for routing the CPU power cables, fan case IO, and fans along the edges of the motherboard. But there is also a nice channel in the center with Velcro straps to keep things locked down, which you're seeing right here. And if you need extra Velcro straps, MSI throws in a few of those as well. Okay, now we're gonna turn it back around. I'm gonna go, oh no, that was terrible. Now that we know what we're looking for and how Project Zero all works together, let's take a look at its performance, because we're looking at an ecosystem and not just a PC case or a pre-built system here. We're gonna look at the thermal performance and gaming in isolation from PC cases and systems we've tested in the past, because technically this is different. While idling, our Project Zero PC averaged 39 degrees Celsius on the CPU and 29 degrees Celsius on the GPU. Under full CPU load, our Project Zero build averaged 80 degrees Celsius with the GPU staying at a very nice 29 degrees Celsius. As for 1440p gaming benchmarks, this is where we saw MSI's Project Zero shine a little bit brighter, with CPU temps averaging 56 degrees Celsius and GPU thermal performance averaging 62 degrees Celsius. The Project Zero build did keep temps balanced, especially when you consider, for all intents and purposes, that this is a smaller build. Overall, as a small PC case with limited air volume to work with inside the case, the M100 handled the heat all right. To be honest, most small form factor builds struggle in thermal tests just by the nature of cramming high powered components into a small space. However, we did notice that the case, when open, could shave up to 3 degrees Celsius off of the averages. That's not that surprising. It just means that airflow could be better, and that's why we're seeing 3 degrees trapped inside. Now, since we ended the thermals on gaming, let's talk about the kind of performance we saw from our Project Zero PC. All of our tests ran in 1440p with DLSS active on balance when available. In Cyberpunk 2077, our Project Zero system ruthlessly ran the streets of Night City at 127 frames per second. These numbers were aided by DLSS frame generation, but this was with ray tracing cranked to ultra and also ray reconstruction. In Forza Horizon 5, with settings cranked to extreme with DLSS frame generation active, we saw an average frame rate of 198 frames per second. In Modern Warfare 3, with graphic presets on extreme and frame generation active, we saw an average of 217 frames per second. That's great for the 7 to 10 minute campaign. In Shadow of the Tomb Raider, with settings at their highest, Project Zero was more hero than zero with an average frame rate of 277 frames per second. And in Tiny Tina's Wonderland, using FSR2 in the absence of DLSS, and with settings turned up to badass, we saw a few zeros from Project Zero, but in the form of an average frame rate of 200.90 frames per second. Now, switching gears to competitive shooters, we optimize frame rates by turning the graphics down to low visual settings, very similar to competitive gamers. In Apex Legends, we saw an average of 296.5 frames per second on low visual settings. And finally, in Fortnite, with TSR set to medium and visual settings on low, we saw an average of 458.7 frames per second. So we built what we believe to be the best MSI optimized Project Zero PC. I feel like we made a balanced build that works well with this PC, works well with this case. It's super performant. But what did we think of the MSI Project Zero ecosystem? Honestly, it builds a really nice and clean PC. And if that's what you're into, Project Zero is a step and an interesting direction. For a first run at this, MSI has given us a solid first showing. However, like any first gen tech or innovation, there is absolutely room for improvement. Here are a few things that we think are worth considering if you're intrigued by MSI's Project Zero and you're thinking about building a build just like this. Thing number one, because there isn't a clear unified standard to our knowledge as of the filming for how motherboards and cases are going to handle back-connect motherboards, your options for compatible cases are going to be limited and designs could absolutely change. We mentioned earlier that Gigabyte had a system called Project Zero that they were test driving a while back, and there are rumors that not just MSI and Gigabyte, but others are also doing this endeavor. If new players enter the market with competing designs, it may be worth waiting to see how back-connect form factors get adopted and what kind of support they gain, because they could have things like AIOs and other components that could be completely back-connect. Now, if you care less about that and you like what you see, you know what? Have at it. It's awesome. With experimental projects like this, if it resonates with consumers like you and like me, they might keep working on it if we buy it, and your dollars are the ultimate vote. Okay, thing number two. If you can help it, use a PSU with ribbon-style cabling over ones with bundled cables. You will absolutely thank us later. There were a few connection points that had some competition for space. Specifically, the front I/O USB connections were fighting for the 24-pin motherboard connection for real estate. Not only that, but these cables were so stiff, they gave us trouble when it came to closing the side panel. We'll bring this up again in just a minute. Thing number three is a bit of a gotcha because it's not as bad as it sounds. Because the Mag Pano M100R was designed for Project Zero, it works very well with the Project Zero Micro ATX motherboard. But say you wanted to swap the motherboard for one with front-facing connections, you can technically do that, but cables are gonna be a little bit out of control. With all that in mind, we have a few thoughts for MSI. First off, we wanna say thank you. Thanks for letting us check this out, but also, you know what? Thank you for taking a risk for something like this. It is a bit unconventional to step outside of standards that have existed for technological generations. And we just want you to know that, you know what? We're here for it. The second thing, and if I could like pull up a chair like Captain America did in that detention video, I would pull up that chair right now, straddle it like William Riker, and I'd say something like, so you designed a case and a motherboard to play outside of the sandbox. Good for you, kid. This fine world needs more innovators like you. But start with the little details before you get too wild and crazy. That little detail is this: make 90 degree connections for USB and power. Either that or include cable extensions with the motherboard to ensure that they have secure fits. Those cables, especially the power cables, are just way too stiff to wrangle. And we had a few moments that we were worried that we weren't gonna be able to get the case closed. We also had a few moments where we were concerned that we were gonna break one of the connections by forcing the cables to fit, that we were causing so much tension on the connections that they weren't actually meant to handle. And we've all seen what happens when you have cables carry that kind of wattage that aren't connected right. Right? We don't want any of those stories about combustible computers to be about you, MSI. We care about you too much. And to be honest, guys, that's not really a fear, but the point is that you just don't want to have too much stress on the cables. With the current components MSI has brought to the table, especially with white, Project Zero sets up a combo that could kickstart a super clean build for novice builders. Now, that doesn't mean it's like paint by numbers. Project Zero has some considerations that a novice builder might not think about, such as wrangling stubborn cables or the possibility of changing standards removing upgrade pathways. But at the end of the day, MSI took a risk with the Project Zero system that is a really welcome one to see. We're really looking forward to seeing this new form factor stick around, and we hope that you love it, because if you do, buy it, because that means we'll get more. Now, as we wrap this up, these are our impressions of MSI's Project Zero, but we want to know what you think. Are you excited to see what companies hop on board the BatConnect bandwagon, or do you like the challenge of making cabling more presentable in your PC case? I'd love to know that down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here on Robeytech. And if you have other questions or want to talk about this more, make sure you join us over at discord.gg/Robeytech, where you can meet people who love to have discussions about this very same thing. And hey, you know what? You might make a friend. Anyway, you can follow us at Robeytech absolutely everywhere. Thank you so much for watching this video, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.